Hello friends, welcome to Indian Defense Flash, where we discuss day-to-day defense updates from India and all around the globe. So let us begin with our today's video. So if we take a look at the specifications of S-500 in brief, then we'll find out that up to 600 kilometers the S-500 is able to destroy any kind of ballistic missile, and up to 500 kilometers it is able to destroy any incoming enemy aircraft, whether stealth or non-stealth. And apart from range, which makes it different from the S-400, the new feature with which it comes is that the S-500 have the capability of anti-satellite, which means that in the low Earth orbit this S-500 is able to destroy enemy satellite, and also the S-500 missile defense system would be able to destroy any ballistic missile which is MIRV capable, that is the missile which could carry more than 10 nuclear warheads, and also in the future this missile defense system would be able to destroy any hypersonic missile. So if we take a look at the statements of the Russian Deputy Prime Minister Yuri Borisov, he has stated that after the completion of the induction of S-500 missile defense system in the Russian armed forces, they would consider it to export to friendly nations like India. But if we take a look at the requirements of the Indian armed forces, then we would find out that as of now India does not require any S-500 missile defense system, because we already have placed an order for S-400, 4 years ago, and within the end of December this year in 2021 the first battery of S-400 will arrive in India, and also India has not even started operating the S-400, so without having any experience of operating the predecessor of S-500, India should not go for S-500. Also at the same time the Defense Research and Development Organization and various other agencies are involved in making different missile defense systems in-house. This type of anti-aircraft missile defense system can take down the enemy aircrafts and cruise missiles at a range up to 400 kilometers, which includes the XR-SAM. And if we come to countering ballistic missiles, India does have a ballistic missile defense shield, and also India does have an anti-satellite weapon to destroy enemy satellites in the low Earth orbit. Simple answer to this question is, that if China decide to buy S-500, then they would have a very much better missile to copy on. Because in the S-400 deal that the Chinese signed with the Russians did not include it, the 400 kilometers range 40N60E missile. But with this S-500 deal, Russia can give the technologies which are far more better than the 40N60 missile which is being used in the S-400, and which could be further used by the Chinese to reverse engineer and make many variants of that missile, and could eventually increase the range of that missile. In simple words, we can say that if China decides to buy S-500, then it would be necessity for India to procure the S-500 so that Indian Air Force can practice and make tactics to counter the Chinese S-500 at the time of war with China. So if we take a look at the advantages of S-500, the main advantage is not that the S-500 is able to destroy enemy aircraft, ballistic missiles, cruise missile or satellites, because as of now India have all kind of systems to counter aircrafts, ballistic missiles, cruise missiles and satellites, but when it comes to countering hypersonic missiles it would be a game changer for India, because as of now there is no missile defense system in the world which can kill any kind of hypersonic missile. And the second advantage is that, if we take a look at the depth of Pakistan, even the S-400 is able to cover almost every part of Pakistan, and if India buys the S-500 then it would make the Pakistani Air Force almost unable to even take off from their bases being undetected. And if situations get tense, then the PAF fighters would also be destroyed by the S-500 in the Pakistani airspace itself at the time of war. S-500 is a very capable air defense system, and if Indian Air Force feels that it should acquire it, that would be very helpful for India to counter any kind of threat coming from both the adversaries, that is China and Pakistan. And but if China decides to procure the S-500, then it should be a necessity for India to purchase S-500 from Russia, so that the Indian Air Force pilots could train themselves accordingly. Thank you for visiting our channel. Please like and share the video and subscribe to our channel to support us on YouTube.